Hi everyone, I'm from the Learning Centre at James Cook University and I'm going to be sharing with you in this webinar today part four of the academic writing process. It's centred on summarising and paraphrasing, two key skills that successful students use to integrate scholarly sources and evidence into their writing. So in this webinar today, we're going to do a quick check-in on how confident and competent you feel about integrating evidence into your assignments. We're going to look at what successful students say and do, and look at a powerful strategy in action that you can implement straight away. We're going to also explore student voices and frequently asked questions about paraphrasing, summarizing, using direct quotes, and ultimately integrating evidence into your own assignment. We'll also have some space at the end of this webinar to look at the chat window questions coming through from real students and think space for you to think about what you will do as a result of participating in this webinar today. So, how confident and competent are you around using scholarly sources in your assignments? Just a very quick check-in from the smiley faces, one being a little confident, two, five being really confident. Where are you positioned right now? So paraphrasing and summarising, all of the resources around paraphrasing, summarising and integrating sources into your work can be found at the link on the slide that you see before you. You can also find fantastic resources from the Learning Centre webpage on the JCU webpage. So what do successful students do? They actually demonstrate what they comprehend and understand in their writing and assessment tasks by integrating evidence from other sources, theory, key concepts and ideas into the actual structure of their assignments. You might be asking at this point, but how do you actually do that? So in this webinar today, I'm going to teach you how to summarise and paraphrase research and readings that you have each week or that you may be using in the lead up to putting together an assignment. So why do we use other people's writing in our own work or other people's ideas in our own work? Basically, it is one of the key ways that your lecturers, your tutors, and ultimately your markers will know what you know and what you can do and what you've managed to read and find out around a discipline or a topic or a theme. So using the work of experts and researchers in various disciplines is a large part of university study. And lecturers want to see that you have read widely on a topic, that you have investigated, perhaps found some resources of your own. And so you will use other people's work in your own writing to show that you have done the reading that you were supposed to do, that week-to-week reading guide. You will also be using other people's work to demonstrate that you have read widely on a topic and to help you set up an argument in your own writing or assignment to reinforce your position or thesis on a topic. So there are key ways to do this, and one that you may know of is quoting, taking a direct quote from someone else's work and putting it into your assignment to use as evidence. Now, with a direct quote, we can tell it is a direct quote because the use of inverted commas are there around the word for word taken from the original source. You also need to reference a direct quote. But what some students don't know is that quoting is only one way of integrating sources. And in fact, taking word verbatim is not going to give you the same results in terms of comprehension and synthesis or demonstrating that synthesis as paraphrasing or summarizing would. So paraphrasing is basically when you take information from an original source and you put it into your own words. And in order to do this successfully, you first must understand what it is that you are reading. So in our previous webinar around taking critical notes, that template that I showed you can be a real key strategy to helping you make sense of the scholarly information that you are locating and finding. Now, one recommended approach is that you cover the original passage so that you can't see it and write down the meaning of that passage in your own words. You must change the structure of the original passage so that it is completely put into your own words. But you will still need to acknowledge where you have taken that source from. So depending on your referencing system, you will need to follow the rules. So make sure that you haven't changed the meaning of the original passage in the paraphrased idea that you've put together. If you are really unsure of how to go about doing this, you can check out some of the other wonderful resources that the Learning Center has on their webpage, as well as maybe even dropping into the Learning Advice Desk and getting some feedback from a student who is already moving through their own degree successfully, or make a one-on-one consult with a learning advisor. You can simply do that by emailing learning@jcu.edu.au. So another key strategy for integrating other people's work into your own assignments is by summarising. Now, it's very similar to paraphrasing, except it's usually reserved for when you only have a short or small amount of space or a few words to put that idea down. You do need to, however, still acknowledge where you got the source from. So, what students really grapple with, especially at the starting point of university, is synthesizing ideas, comprehending and synthesizing, not just laying down every single idea from the literature sentence by sentence. So synthesis is a really important part of the academic process, and it's much more than making a list or listing sentence by sentence all the ideas that you have found. You need to show and demonstrate that you have interpreted the information, understood it, and importantly, made connections between the pieces of information. So in order to do that, you will need to identify what information is the same and different as you interpret the information and draw on a number of sources. You can actually draw on multiple sources as you synthesize information in your assignment. So I could talk at length about the different strategies, but what does it actually look like in practice? Well, I've got a sample of real student writing here, a couple of body paragraphs this student has created for an education assignment. And if you have a look at the paragraphs and the blue underlined sections, you will see references, in-text citations that draw on the work of others. And so you will see in this particular referencing system, APA referencing system, authors and dates to indicate where the ideas have actually come from. But if you skim and scan through these paragraphs, you will see down in the bottom body paragraph 3 that Brown's reference is a part of a direct quote. There's a particular term there that has been used as a direct quote, and you will see that there is a page number to acknowledge this direct quote. But if we skim and scan back up to body paragraph 1, what you will notice is there are no direct, inverted commas rather, but there are sentences that really draw on or synthesize the ideas from the key theorists there. So this is where the student has paraphrased the ideas and put them together, combined them with one or two or three readings to really synthesize the information. So it's a really good tip for students to have a look at the writing of other students and great scholarly samples week by week as you read your set readings to look at how theorists and lecturers and academics have integrated sources by paraphrasing, summarizing, and using direct quotes. So they are the three key strategies that you can use in your own writing to show how widely you've read on a topic, how you've synthesized and interpreted information, and perhaps drawing implications from that. You can find more resources on the writing libguide around summarizing and paraphrasing if you'd like more on this today. So let's now dive into some top tips from a real student. Okay, the first thing that comes up here is that students often share how they spend most of their time looking for amazing direct quotes. And yes, direct quotes are one way that you can integrate sources, but they don't necessarily show a great deal of synthesis. So as you're putting together your assignments, make sure that you are also paraphrasing and summarizing. Another really powerful strategy that real students have shared is valuable to them is the Manchester Phrase Bank. You can access the Manchester Phrase Bank from the link on the slide that you see before you. But inside this amazing dynamic resource is literally a bank of words that you can use to help you report and connect ideas. It can help you be more critical with your writing. And if you're grappling with the right words to introduce someone else's idea into your writing, there are really great examples to use there. So taking action today is all about coming back to how we started this session. How confident are you now about looking at how you will integrate sources into your writing through using direct quotes, paraphrasing and summarizing? And what's the one thing that you will do as a result of participating in this webinar today? Hopefully, you will be looking at some of the additional resources we have in the Learning Center and on the Writing LibGuide. But ultimately, I hope you walk away with this idea that you'll be using things like the scholarly note-taking template and the critical note-taking templates to pull out ideas from what you are reading, to acknowledge the sources and put page numbers down if it's a direct quote so you can integrate them into your assignments. But using those three strategies, paraphrasing, summarizing, and using direct quotes. If you are concerned about your writing and plagiarism and academic integrity, you can go to the below link on this slide and find out more information. So there's only one last thing to talk about in this webinar today, and it's what successful students also do. They stay connected. So be sure to check out the Learning Center Facebook page and also the Learning Center webpage from the JCU webpage. And also think about other additional resources that will support you. So Studiosity is a 24/7 resource that you can submit your assignment to get feedback around the writing demands, and there are other strategies and skills and aspects of Studiosity that you can use. You can actually book a live session with someone to go through your assignment and seek feedback. But don't forget, we also have the Learning Advice Desk on the ground floor of the libraries in Townsville and Cairns, and you can also make an appointment to see a learning advisor. Whether you're studying internally or externally, you can simply email learning@jcu.edu.au. I hope this webinar has inspired you to think about how you'll integrate sources into your own work. And if you are interested in looking for more, please be sure to check out the resources.